Hello children, welcome to the second part of the lesson, Uncle Bodger hangs a picture. Let us have a recap of the first part. In that, a photo frame comes from the frame maker. Aunt Bodger asks Uncle Bodger what should be done with it. Then Uncle Bodger takes the responsibility to hang it on the wall. He makes all the people in the house busy, telling them to do some or the other work. He sends one to bring the nails, one to bring the kitchen chair, etc. When trying to fix the frame on the wall, he breaks the glass and his finger is cut. And then searches for the handkerchief to tie on it. And then finds that his coat is missing, in which he had kept the handkerchief. After finding the coat, he ties the handkerchief to the finger and starts the work again. Then he drops the nail and asks everyone to find it. Reading time. The nail would be found at last, but by the time he would have lost the hammer. Where is the hammer? What did I do with the hammer? Great heavens, seven of you gaping around there and you don't know what I did with the hammer. We would find the hammer for him and then he would have lost the sight of the mark he had made on the wall. Where the nail was to go in, and each of us had to get up on the chair beside him and see if we could find it. And we would each discover it in a different place. And he would call all of us fools, one after another, and tell everyone to get down. And he would take the rule and remeasure and find that he wanted half 31 3/8 inches from the corner, and would try to do it in his head and go mad. Now, after everyone searches for the nail and finds the nail and give it to Uncle Bodger. By the time he would have lost the hammer which was in his right hand. Then he would ask everyone, where is the hammer? What did I do with the hammer? And he scolds everyone, seven of them, that they don't know what he did with the hammer. After that, everyone searches for the hammer and they find that. Then, after finding the hammer, where he has put the mark, where the nail should go in, he has lost that. Then again, he asked all the children to get on the chair beside him and find the mark. Then everyone would search for the mark and find it in a different place. Then all the people were called as fools by Uncle Bodger. Then again they were asked to get down, and Uncle Bodger would remeasure with the ruler to find the mark. He wanted half 31 8 inches from the corner, and he would try to calculate the distance in his head and he would go mad. Reading time. And we would all try to do it in our heads and all arrive at different results and sneer at one another. And in the general row, the original number would be forgotten and Uncle Bodger would have to measure it again. As you can see in the picture, all the people were trying to calculate the distance where the frame should go onto the wall, and all arrive at different results. And everyone look at each other as if they don't have any respect to other, by showing a different kind of expression on the face. And in every noisy argument, one is telling 42, one is telling 22, and all this argument, the original number which was 31 8 inches is lost. And again Uncle Bodger would have to take the rule and measure it. Reading time again. Look into the book and see where I am reading, children. He would use a bit of string this time, and at the critical moment when the old fool was leaning over the chair at an angle of 45 and trying to reach a point 3 inches beyond what was possible for him to reach, the string would slip and down he would slide onto the piano. A really fine musical effect being produced by the suddenness with which his head and body struck all the notes at the same time. And Aunt Maria would say that she would not allow the children to stand around and hear such language. At last, Uncle Bodger would get the spot fixed again and put the point on the nail on it with his left hand and take the hammer in his right hand. And with the first blow, he would smash his thumb and dropped the hammer with a yell on somebody's toes. Aunt Maria could madly observe that next time Uncle Podgar was going to hammer a nail into the wall, she hoped she would let her know in time so that she could make arrangements to go and spend a week with her mother while it was being done. "Oh, you make such a fuss over everything," Uncle Podgar would reply, picking up himself. "Why, I like doing a little job of this sort." Then after that, finding the remeasuring, again finding the point where the nail should go into the well, this time the string, he will take the string to hang the picture. And at this critical moment, Uncle Podgar was leaning on the chair at an angle of 45. He was trying to reach a point 3 inches away where it was possible for him to reach. Beyond his reach, he was leaning on the chair. At that time, the chair would slip and he would fall on the piano. And when the uncle's body falls on the piano with suddenness, head and the body struck all the notes of the piano. Notes of the piano means the white and black buttons with which people will play music. He will fall on that notes so that the musical tone will be coming out, and he would be shouting at the children. Then Uncle Aunt Maria would say that, "I would not allow children to stand around because you are speaking such a language." Then again, Uncle Podgar get the fixed point and put the nail on it with the left hand, and he would hold the hammer in the right hand and try to hit that. With the first blow, he would, instead of hitting the nail, he would hit the thumb, and then with a yell, yell means shouting loudly, he will throw the hammer on somebody's toes. All the children were standing around him, so he would throw the hammer on somebody's toes. Then Aunt Maria, mildly observing all these things, tell Uncle Podgar that next time whenever you are doing some work, tell me before in time only so that I can go to my mother and stay there for 1 week till you finish your work in this house. Then Uncle Podgar starts shouting at her that you create all the confusion here, you make a mess out of here. Whenever I try to do a little job also, you will be always shouting at me and telling me that you will go to your mother's house. And then he would have another try, and at the second blow, the nail would blow clean through the plaster and half the hammer after it. And Uncle Podgar be precipitated against the wall with the force nearly sufficient to flatten his nose. Then we had to find the rule and the string again. Now a new hole was made, and about midnight the picture would be up, very crooked and insecure. The walls for yards around as if it had been smoothed down with a rake, and everybody dead beat and rich except Uncle Podgar. "There you are," he would say, stepping down heavily off the chair onto the carwoman's cons and surveying the mess he had made with evident pride. Why, some people would have had a man in to do a little thing like that. Then after that he would find out the point where the nail has to be fixed. Then after that, he had blown a second blow. Then with the second hit, how hard he had it, the nail would go into the hole and the plaster, the white color smooth one which we'll put on the wall. Then half the hammer also, it would have gone into the plaster. Then Uncle Podgar, looking at that, flattened his nose as he was putting his face against the wall. Then all the people should find the rule again, where it is, the string again. Then again a hole was made, and the work would have finished at midnight. In the midnight, up to 12 o'clock, the frame would be hanged on the wall. The picture would be up. And it was very crooked and insecure. It was fixed cross, whole wall was with cracks. Then as if it was raked with the rake. You can see in the pictures or in the JCB how the nails will be, if you scratch with that, how scratches will be on the floor. Same like that, scratches will be on the wall. So here, everyone would be dead beat means everyone will be frightened. What happened to the wall? How it is? But Uncle Podger was very, with pride, he is looking at the picture how he has hanged. Then he would get down on the car woman's cons. Means sometimes after working long time in the water or what is the car woman? He is a maid in the house. She would be working with the water, cleaning dishes and what. Then some kind of hurt will be there in the fingers of the legs, that is toes. So while getting down from the chair, Uncle Podger lands on the car woman's cans or the toes which were hurt. Then he would evidently pride. He was very proud that he had fixed the picture on the wall. And he will survey all the work. Where is the string, remaining string? Where are the remaining nails? Where is the hammer, kitchen chair? These all things he will survey. Means he look at everything, what mess he has created. And at the end he will say that, why will everyone ask a man to do this little work? Then all will be looking at the face of Uncle Podger in surprising way. This is how Uncle Podger hangs a picture on the wall. Everyone will be surprised to see the picture on the wall. Thank you, children. Have a nice day.